Election denying, super sore loser Kari Lake is drowning in her own lake of tears. Judge Peter Thompson ruled on December 24th against Lake's filing the 2022 election had been tampered with. Kari "Cry Me a Lake" then posted and then deleted a conspiracy about the judge, attacking his ethics, of course, evidence free. Mark Elias posted a few days ago, "I asked what conspiracy theory Kari Lake would offer for why she lost her election contest lawsuit. It's more insane than I ever predicted." Kari tweets, "The dismissal of Kari Lake's election lawsuit shows voter disenfranchisement no longer matters." Continuing the third person all these people are doing lately, at @rach_ic, "Legal experts believe his decision by Judge Thompson was ghostwritten. They suspect top left-wing attorneys like Mark Elias emailed him what to say." They suspect, they think, they hope. None of it's true, none of it's based in anything. Of course, Judge Thompson's the one that found the court did not have any clear evidence of widespread misconduct that could have impacted the results of the 2022 midterm election. During a two-day trial, Lake's team focused on ballot printer issues in Maricopa County, asking the judge to declare her governor or order a revote in the county. That's your options. Declare the loser governor or do an expensive revote. Because of why? Because of printer problems. Printers run out of ink, Kari. That's not election fraud, just the nature of printers. We all know that. But turnabout is fair game, and hopefully justice will boomerang right back at Lake's democracy ruining ways. Maricopa County has filed a motion on Monday for sanctions against former Republican gubernatorial candidate Kari Lake. The motion was joined later on Monday by Arizona's governor-elect Katie Hobbs. I like that she's stepping on to that motion. She defeated Lake and is now seeking attorney's fees and expenses, requesting about $37,000 paid as a sanction. All told, however, it could be much higher than that. Between Hobbs and several lawyers for the county, Lake and her attorneys could face up to $700,000 in sanctions to cover total fees, according to Justin Lum. That would be a little good bit of justice. Kari Lake, of course, says she will appeal the ruling. The only appeal this disgusting person could possibly ever have, because it sure ain't there in her personality. Jackson, we got a minute left. What are your thoughts on this?
I mean, it's always astounding to me when people like this run for office in the first place, let alone the whole strategy being ridiculous, that you know anyone with two pairs of eyes or a half an eye could have seen that the strategy was a losing one. You know, people like Kari Lake, who was a successful broadcaster before she even got in office, she didn't need to do this. You know, you look at what's her name, Dr. Oz. Now his career really, I mean, he still got money, but moving forward, he just really isn't in a good position brand wise, and he never should have stepped foot in the race. So Kari Lake really is just embarrassed, but there's nothing she can do to erase the fact that she ran a ridiculous campaign on a foundation of lies and she just lost. And so now moving forward, you know, she's gonna look like a joke and a clown, but that's the bed she made for herself.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.